Then I switched to the Gramercy Arts Theatre. In between, we had some other screenings, actually, between the Charles and the Gramercy. We had some screenings at the Bleeker Street Cinema, and we were thrown out there also from the Bleeker Street Cinema under the same pretext, really. The manager of the theater, it was not Lionel Rogosin, who was the owner, but said that we are ruining their reputation, that we are our audience, their audience is so different from our audience that their audience, when they see this other audience, they next time they won't come to that theater. So after three or four weekend screenings, we were thrown out. I think that's where we had some shows on Broadway West somewhere at the, I think, a little gallery that Jackson Pollock's girlfriend, somebody, was running. We had, and then we rented out the Gramercy Arts Theatre. We were thrown out from many places in those days.
And you also had a policy that people...
Including writer's stage on 4th Street. We could not have any screenings after the arrest. That's where, after this arrest and seizure of Flaming Creatures, when everybody... When everybody said I'm in trouble because there was, you know, Lenny Bruce case going, was just I just completed, and he lost the case, so that in my case they thought was worse. So I thought, okay, then I will make it even more worse. If it's so, then I screened Jeanette's film. Two weeks later, and I was arrested, of course, again. But the idea, it was my calculation that Genet had already a certain reputation in New York. The balcony, and I think the maids, maybe, had opened. And so that I'm arrested for a Genet film made by Genet, actually, by Nico Papatakis. It will be make the case for them more difficult. Where Jack Smith, you know, who is, you know, nobody. So it was sort of calculated. So calculated that I had a sandwich, you know, I knew I will be arrested. I had a sandwich, a chicken in my pocket. And when I introduced the screening, I noticed already police in the audience, and I addressed them. I said, I know, you know, you're the police. So please, you know, have a good time. Watch the film. of course, I was arrested and in prison, and I pulled out my chicken. And then there is this voice in the next cell, you could see, and you see there is this black guy watching greedily my chicken. So I, you know, split the chicken, I gave him, you know, squeezed in half of the chicken, and we had good supper. So a year later, I walk, it was more like 3 or 4 years later, I walk somewhere, something not far from here, and this black guy, you know, comes up. You remember me? I said, who are you? I don't know. You gave me half of your chicken in jail.